I'm here with a good friend of mine, Becky, who has narcolepsy, and we're going to talk to her a little bit more about it. So when were you first diagnosed with narcolepsy?
Probably is the end of my freshman year of high school, and I had good sleep habits. Like, I had younger siblings, so I still went to bed at 9 o'clock at night, 10 o'clock maybe at the latest, and I was still so tired. Like, I would come home from school and I would take a nap right away, and I was playing soccer, so sometimes I'd be at soccer practice and then take a nap and wake up and go to my next soccer practice. And I was also falling asleep in a lot of my classes. We went to Finding Nemo and I fell asleep in it, and I wasn't tired. It was the last day of school. I was super excited to be summer break, and then I went out a couple weeks later and fell asleep like almost the same time in the movie again for only like 10 minutes, and then I woke up. So that's when I realized, like, why am I so tired? And then my parents kind of just thought I was being like a lazy teenager. And then I started to show the signs of cataplexy, where you lose muscle control during strong emotions. So when I would laugh, my mom started noticing that my facial features, they kind of like droop because you just can't control them, and my neck would like drop. And she started noticing that, so that's when we decided to go to a doctor. So we went to a general practitioner that we'd never used before, and we told him my symptoms, and he was like, "Have you done drugs?" And I was like, "No, I've never done anything. I had never even drank alcohol at all yet." And he was like, "So you've never done this, this, this," listed like 10 drugs, and I'm like, "No, no, no, no." And he's like, "Then I don't know what you have." So then we went to my pediatrician, and we told him, like, she's tired all the time and she loses muscle control. And he was like, "I think you have narcolepsy." And then I went to a pediatric neurologist. Right away, she was like, "You can't drive anymore." And that was like right when I got my permit, so I was really upset about that. And then I did the EEG and a 24-hour sleep study at a center. And lastly, they did an MRI in my head, and then I got diagnosed with narcolepsy.
What is it like to live with narcolepsy?
It's kind of just something that's always in the back of my head, like, and my parents and my fiance, like, whenever I'm gonna drive anywhere, they're like, "Make sure you're not too tired." Every day is different. Like, sometimes I'll have to take a nap at 2 o'clock, and sometimes I'll wanna take a nap at work at like 10:30 in the morning. And usually when I do take a nap, I really only need to sleep for like 10 minutes and I'll feel refreshed. So I'll just literally lay my head down on my desk and I'll fall asleep in like 20 seconds and I'll set a timer and then I'll wake back up. Luckily, at my job I have right now, I have my own office, so I'll just like close the door to my office and just lay down on my desk. But it's something I always think about. Like, the other day I wanted to like rush and go to the gym and then rush and meet my mom somewhere, and it was kind of across town, and I was like, "Can I drive? Like, should I lay down for 15 minutes and take a nap?" So I always have to think about that. When I was working at my job before this, I was like clocked out on a break, and I went into like a back room and I set my timer and I fell asleep in like a chair like this. And my boss came in and she suspended me for taking a nap at work. And I was like so upset. I was like, "Here's my timer. I was gonna go off in like 1 minute." And I was like, "I have narcolepsy," which I wrote on my application. And then the next day I brought like my note from my neurologist that said I have narcolepsy, and they paid me for the hours that I missed and everything, but I was very upset when I got in trouble for taking a nap.
Is there anything that you want to tell people about the disorder?
I kind of want people to know that there are a lot of different levels and like extremities of narcolepsy. Like, a lot of people, when I tell them I have narcolepsy, they're really surprised. And then they bring up that one Deuce Bigelow movie where the girl's like trying to bowl. And I guess some people can fall asleep like mid-sentence, but I can't. So sometimes it kind of annoys me that people are like, "Oh, can you fall asleep right now?" I'm like, "No, I can't. If I try to fall asleep at any time, I will, but not while I'm doing something." It really bothers me when people that I guess don't know I have narcolepsy or forget I do think it's funny when I do fall asleep somewhere. And I guess another thing I want people to know is a really odd symptom of narcolepsy is that it's really hard to sleep at night, because I guess since you go into REM sleep so fast that I never sleep for more than like 3 hours straight. I always will wake up. So I like get a good night's sleep, but I will wake up at least like 10 times a night and just be awake for like a minute, and then I'll fall back asleep.